Good morning, students. Let's begin our lecture. Organization of the primary health care. The ultimate goal of primary health care is better health for all. World Health Organization has identified five key elements to achieving this goal: reducing exclusion and social disparities in health, universal coverage reforms, organization health services around people's needs and expectations, service delivery performance, integrating health into all sectors, public policy reforms, pursuing collaborative models of policy dialogue, leadership reforms, and increasing stakeholder participation. What is components of the primary health care? Education concerning prevailing health problem and methods of preventing and controlling them. Promotion of food supply and proper nutrition. An adequate supply of safe water and basic sanitation. Maternal and child health, including family planning. Immunization against major infection disease, prevention and control of locally endemic diseases, appropriate treatment of common diseases and injuries, provision of essential drugs. What is prevention? The goals of medicine are to promote health, to preserve health, to restore health visits impaired, and to minimize suffering and distress. These goals are embodied in the word prevention. Actions aimed at eradication, eliminating or minimizing the impact of disease and disability, or if none of these are feasible, retarding the progress of the disease and disability. The concept of prevention is best defined in a context of levels, traditionally called primary, secondary, and tertiary prevention. Fourth level, called primordial prevention, was later added. Stages of disease. Pre-disease, the level is primary prevention, and type of response, this is health promotion or specific protection. If latent disease, this is secondary prevention. Type of response is pre-symptomatic diagnosis and treatment. And symptomatic disease, this is tertiary prevention. Disability limitation for early symptomatic disease. Rehabilitation for late symptomatic disease. Now, these are four levels of prevention. Primordial prevention, primary, secondary, and tertiary. Primordial prevention consists of action and measures that inhibit the emergence of risk factors in the form of environmental, economic, social, and behavioral conditions and cultural patterns of living, etc. It is the prevention of the emergence development of risk factor in countries or population groups. in which they have not yet appeared. For example, many adult health problems, for example, obesity, hypertension, have their early origin in childhood, because this is a time when lifestyles are formed, for example, smoking, eating patterns, physical exercise. In primordial prevention, efforts are directed towards discouraging children from adopting harmful lifestyles. The main intervention is in primordial prevention is through individual and mass education. Primary prevention be defined as the action taken prior to the onset of disease, which removes the possibility that the disease will ever occur. It signified intervention in the pre-pathogenesis phase of disease or health problem. Primary prevention may be accomplished by measures of health promotion and specific protection. Health promotion is the process of enabling people to increase control over and to improve health. It is not directed against any particular disease, but is intended to strengthen the host through a variety of approaches, interventions. The well-known interventions in this area are health education, environmental modifications, nutritional intervention, lifestyle and behavioral changes. Environmental modifications. A comprehensive approach to health promotion requires environmental modifications, such as provision of safe water, installation of sanitary latrines, control of insects and rodents, improvement of housing, etc. This history of medicine has shown that many infectious diseases have been successfully controlled in Western countries through environmental modifications. Even prior to the development of specific vaccines or chemotherapeutic drugs. Environmental intervention is non-clinical and do not involve the physician. Nutritional interventions. These comprise food distribution and nutrition, improvement of vulnerable groups, child feeding programs, food fortification, nutrition education. Lifestyle behavior changes. The conventional public health measures or intervention have not been successful in making inroads into lifestyle reforms. The action of prevention in this case is one of the individual and community responsibility for health. The physician and, in fact, each health worker acting as an indicator, then a therapist. Health education is a basic element of all health activity. It is of paramount importance in changing the views, behavior, and habits of people. To avoid disease, specific protection to avoid disease altogether is the ideal, but this is possible only in a limited number of cases. The currently available intervention in this area are immunization, use a specific nutrients, Hemoprophylaxis, protection against occupational hazards, protection against accidents, protection from carcinogens, avoidance of allergens, the control of specific hazards in the general environment, air pollution, noise control, control of consumer product quality and safety of food, drugs, cosmetics. What is approaches for primary prevention? The World Health Organization has recommended the following approaches for primary prevention of chronic disease where the risk factors are established. This is population mass strategy and high risk strategy. Population mass strategy is directed as the whole population, irrespective of individual risk levels. For example, studies have shown that even a small reduction in the average blood pressure or serum cholesterol of the population would produce a large reduction in the incidence of cardiovascular disease. The population approach is directed towards socioeconomic, behavioral, and lifestyle changes. High risk strategy aims to bring preventive care to individuals at specific risk. This requires detection of individuals at high risk by optimum use of clinical methods. Secondary prevention. It is defined as action which halts the progress of a disease at its incipient stage and prevent complication. It attempts to arrest the disease process, restore health by seeking out unrecognized disease and treating it before irreversible pathological changes take place and reverse communicability of infectious disease. The specific intervention in secondary prevention are early diagnosis, for example, screening test and case finding program, adequate early treatment. Tertiary prevention. It is used when the disease process have advanced beyond its early stage. It is defined as all the measures available to reduce or limit impairments and disabilities and to promote the patient adjustment to irremediable conditions. Intervention are disability limitation and rehabilitation. Disability is any restriction of lack of ability to perform an activity in the manner or within the range considered normal for the human being. Rehabilitation is combined and coordinated use of medical, social, educational, and vocational measures for training and retraining the individual to the highest possible level of functional ability. Screening. The testing of apparently healthy populations to identify previously undiagnosed diseases or people at high risk of developing a disease. How good Does a screening test have to be? It depends on seriousness of disease, consequences of high false positivity rate. High false positivity rate. A rapid HIV test should have more than 90% of sensitivity and 99.9% of specificity. Screen for a neurocytent children proposed 80% sensitivity and more than 95% of specificity. Prenatal genetic questionnaire should be 99% of sensitive and 80% specific. Types of screening. Mass screening. No selection of population. For example, checking all infants for hearing problems. Selective screening. For example, by age and sex. Mammograms for women aged over 40. Multi-phase screening, a series of tests as family doctor do an annual health exam. For example, HIV screening in high-risk pregnant women. What is the organization of primary public health services in Russian Federation? Establishment in primary health care in Russia is policlynic, render the territorial polyclinics serving adults population. It can be children polyclinics and female consultation. So we see three establishment polyclinic, children polyclinics and female consultation. The last two protect the motherhood and the childhood. A modern polyclinic is a large multi-field treatment and prophylactic establishment intended to render medical aid at outpatient reception hours and at home, and also to release a complex of preventive action on improvement of the population health and prevention of diseases. Main aspects of work of the municipal polyclinic. Medical diagnostic work, including selection for sanatorium treatment, examination of temporary disability, reference to medical social examination. Preventive work. Organizational methodical work, which is management, planning, statistical accounting and reporting, analysis of activity, improvement of professional skills. Educational work in population. Popularization of a health lifestyle. The basic organizational methodical principles of work. District principle, attaching to a medical post of normative number of inhabitants. Dispensarization method, regular active supervision over a state of health of the setting contingent. Accessibility of primary health care and preventive orientation of primary health care. The basic scheduled normative parameters. The district specification, the 1,700 patients on the post of the local therapist. Norm of local therapist loading, 5 visits at 1 hour in a polyclinic and 2 visits at home. The function of physical position, or the function of physician position. Number of visits per year for one post of doctor. The regular specification of local therapists, 5.9 on 10,000 inhabitants, more senior than 18 years old. The head of a polyclinic has the right to change these parameters depending on local conditions. A function of the district physician therapist. Rendering of the qualified medical aid in specialty internal diseases during outpatient reception hours and at home. Provide preventive care, dispensarization and hygienic popularization. Timely hospitalization of patient in accordance with established order. Organization of consultation of patient with doctors and other specialties. Realization of medical and rehabilitation activities in outpatient establishment. Realization of examination of temporary disability and reference to medical social examination. Analysis health status of the served population. Reorganization of outpatient polyclinic service in Russia will pass in a direction of creation of Institute of Family Doctors, General Practitioners. General Practitioners is the expect widely focused in the basic medical specialties and capable to render the multi-field outpatient medical aid for the most widespread disease and urgent condition. General practitioner is the highly skilled expert of a primary link at pre-hospital stage. Number of a served contingent at the doctor of the general common practice 150 adult person at the family doctors in view of the children's population no more than 100 to 1200 person in all year age. Duties of the general practitioners. General practitioners should know the demographic and medio-social characteristic of the attached contingent, promote healthy lifestyle, give recommendation for questions of feeding, preparation of children for preschool establishment, advice about family planning, carry out anti-epidemic action, revealing the primary health and latent form of disease and risk factors, organization of all complex and of diagnosis, medical improving and rehabilitation actions. Diagnostics of pregnancy and supervision of a current of pregnancy. Treatment estrogenital disease, revealing the contraindications to pregnancy, a direction on interruption, conducting the postnatal period. Organization help together with establishment of social security and services of mercy for lonely, aged and disabled people and chronic ill patients, including placement of patient in houses, boarding schools, and so forth. Carrying out the medical social examination, the analysis of a state of health in the attached continent, conducting their registration, accounting documentation. And the next, this is dispensarization. This is prophylactic medical examination. Dispensarization is a main method of secondary prophylactic using in primary health care. Dispensary method is regular active supervision over a state of health of the certain groups of patients, which include active early revelation, dynamic follow-up, complex sanitation. In Russian Federation, the periodical medical examination are performed one time per 3 years for the people aged more than 18. The list of tests is regulated by order of Ministry of Health of Russian Federation. Dispensarization is performed in two steps. The first is screening, the second is additional examination and diagnosis if screening reveals some changes. First step of dispensarization include anamnesis and physical examination, anthropometry, BP measurement, cholesterol blood level, glucose blood level, cardiovascular risk in person before 65 years old, ECG in men more than 35 and women more than 45 years old, or in the first periodical exam. Gynecological exam, fluorography of lungs, mammography for women 39 and more years old. Clinical CBC, blood biochemistry for person 39 and more, one time to 6 years. General urine analysis, blood prostate specific antigen in men more than 50 years old. First step of dispensarization includes ultrasound examination of abdomen. This continuation. Ultrasound examination of abdomen in persons more than 39 years old, one time to 6 years. Measurement of ocular pressure in persons 39 and more. Consultation of neurologist in patient more than 50, one time to 6 years, and consultation of therapeutist. Periodical medical examination is result to divided person for three health group: persons without chronic disease and low cardiovascular risk, persons without chronic disease and high cardiovascular risk, persons with chronic disease for medical follow-up or suspicion of chronic disease for additional examination. Person with chronic disease reviewed on periodical medical examination or other visits of doctor to be determined in dispensary group for medical follow-up of therapeutist, family doctor or general practitioner or specialists. Frequency of visit of this patient is regulated by order of Minister of Health of Russian Federation. The next, this is examination of disability. This kind of expertise, which is to determine the causes, duration, degree of temporary or permanent loss of human capacity for work due to illness, injury to other cause, and as well as the determination of the patient's health care needs and the kinds of measures of social protection. Temporary disability, a state of the human body caused by disease, trauma, and other causes in which the functions are accompanied by violation of inability to perform professional work in normal operating condition for a certain period of time, that is, it is reversible. The document certified temporary disability citizens and confirming their temporary release from work is the disability certificate. Permanent disability. A prolonged or permanent disability or significant its restriction caused by chronic disease, trauma, anatomical defects, which lead to a marked disruption or permanent disruption of the body's functions. Depending on the degree of permanent disability, disability is established by means of medical and social expertise. Medical social expertise, the definition of the needs of testing individual in the social protection measures on the basis of an assessment of life instruction caused by persistent disorders of body function. There are three groups of disability in the Russian Federation. Group one, citizens completely loss of ability to regular professional work in normal conditions and is need of permanent home care. With assistance or supervision. Group 2 is set in the event of permanent or long-term disability without the need for nursing care. Group 3, significant reduction or in disability. Estimation of activity of municipal polyclinic. The analysis of activity of outpatient polyclinic establishment is carried out for the improvement of organization of work in municipal polyclinic, current and forward planning of their activity, evaluation of efficiency of various methods of treatment,
Elevation of efficiency of diagnostic, new medical technologies and new form of organization work. Elevation of quality or rendering of the primary medical aid to urban population. Так, сейчас let's continue our lecture. The next topic is principles of diagnostics and treatment of elderly people. Theories of age. How and why we age are still not clear. Why do we age? Many theories none fully explain aging. The rate of living theory of aging is rejected. The oxidative damage-free radical hypothesis of aging, the evolutionary senescence theory of aging, most accepted. The reliability theory of aging and neuroendocrine hypothesis of aging. Physiology of aging. Gerontologist aging is a simulative effects of many lifelong influences. Influences by influences by heredity, environment, culture, diet, exercise, past illness, etc. Genetic factors chiefly determine variation in aging. Lifespan, we exert no control. However, we can control our environmental lifestyle in insults to aging and health. Normal aging in the absence of disease is a remarkably benign process. Biologic and chronologic ages are not as the same. Most organs gradually lose some function, noticeable only during exertion stress. Slower reaction time are common. Physical implications of aging. On skin, loss of underlying connective tissues, fat and oil glands, wrinkles, sagging skin. Aging skin appears thinner, paler, and translucent. Increased sensitivity to heat, cold, bruising, and wet sores. Develops age spots due to deposits of melanin pigment. Hair loses pigmentation, turns hair gray or white. Alopecia, baldness. Hair loss is the norm. Cardiovascular system. Reduce maximal heart rate, dilatation of aorta, reduce elasticity of aorta, reduce number of pacing myocytes in the essay note. Clinical consequences. Reduce exercise tolerance. Calcification of the heart valves, widened pulse pressure, increased risk of postural hypotension, atherosclerosis, overall reduction in blood flow, increased risk of high BP, heart attack, stroke, heart failure, atrial fibrillation. Respiratory system, changing with aging, this is reduced lung elasticity and valvular support, increased chest wall rigidity, reduced immune function, and clinical consequences, decreased vital capacity and peak expiratory volume, flow, increased residual volume, reduced oxygen saturation, increased risk of infection. Musculoskeletal system, reduced bone mineral density, progressive loss of muscle mass. Clinical consequences, increased risk of osteoporosis, increased risk of osteoarthritis. Gastrointestinal system, reduced in stomach hydrochloric acid, digestive enzymes, saliva, reduced motility. Clinical consequences, this impaired swallowing, reduced breakdown and absorption of foods, deficiencies in vitamin B, C, and K. Malnutrition is a real possibility. Constipation. Kidneys changing with age. This is loss of nephrons, reduced glomerular filtration rate, reduced tubular function. Clinical consequences, impaired fluid balance, increased risk of degradation and dehydration overload, impaired drug metabolism and excretion, increased risk of urinary tract infection. Endocrinal disease, reduced tissue sensitivity to insulin and increased risk of impaired glucose tolerance. Immune system, overall effectiveness decreases, lead to increased infection risk, decreased ability to fight disease, slowed wound healing, autoimmune disorders, cancers. Female reproductive system. Menopause is obvious milestone of aging. Cessation of periods more than 1 year. Secretion of estrogens, progesterone, and prolactin hormones are reduced. Prolapse descent of uterus may occur due to lax tissues. Breast cancer risk increase with age. Male reproductive system. Men do not experience a sudden andropause. Age is not a good predictor of male fertility. Testosterone levels may decrease slightly. Rectal dysfunction may occur. Increased risk of hyperplasia and cancer of prostate. The central nervous system changing with age. This is a neuronal loss, cochlear degeneration, increased lens rigidity, lens opacification, anterior horn cell loss, dorsal column loss. What is clinical consequences? Increased risk of organic confusion, presbyacusis, high tone hearing loss, presbyopia, abnormal near vision. Cataract, muscle weakness and wasting, reduced position and vibration sense, delirium, dementia, and severe memory loss are not a normal process of aging. Changes in senses. Hearing, 30% of people over 65 have impairment. Visual, usually need glasses by 55. Only 15-20% have decreased driving ability. Taste, minimal changes. Smell, decreased after 70, may affect gigion. Touch, gradual reduction after 50, injuries, hypothermia. Risk factors for cognitive decline. High blood pressure, diabetes, poor nutrition and social isolation. Heart disease, family history of dementia. Physiological factors like stress and depression. Active aging. Active aging is the process of optimizing opportunity for health, participation and security in order to enhance quality of life as people age. Aging is a social phenomenon, involves friends, work, associates, neighbors, family. Disability-free life expectancy is important to an aging population. This is determinants of active aging. Prescription for prevention. Hippocrates, the father of medicine, said nearly 2040 years ago, if we could give every individual the right amount of nourishment and exercise, not too little and not too much, we would have found the safest way to health. What is healthy eating? Tips for older adults. Recommend a daily calorie consumption for people over age 50. For women, 160 calories. If physical activity is low level, 180 calories of moderate activity and 2000 calories for active lifestyle. For men, 2000 calories if low activity of patient, 2020 to sound 2400 calories for moderate level of activity and 2400 to 800 calories for an active lifestyle. How much physical activity levels vary from person to person? Most people require 30 minutes of moderate physical activity daily. Exercise intensity is less important than total amount spent exercising. Intermittent exercise is as effective as continuous activity. If patient asks, can I take alcohol safely? Yes. Drinking a small amount, 1-2 units per day, protect against health, disease and stroke. Recommended weekly limits for men, maximum 21 units of alcohol per week, not more than 4 units in any one day. Women, 14 units of alcohol per week, not more than 3 units in any one day. Units, 1 unit of alcohol is 10 milliliters by volume or 8 grams by weight of pure alcohol. Smoking is no. On average, smoker diet 13 to 14 years earlier than non-smokers. Respiratory health. The risk of dying from lung cancer is 22 times higher in men and 12 times in women who smoke cigarettes. Compare with never smoker. Smoking tenfold increased risk of dying from chronic obstructive lung disease like emphysema bronchitis. Steps to healthy aging. Monitoring your own health is a good adage. Chronic disease like diabetes, high BP, obesity, etc. cause most problem in old age. Most chronic diseases can be delayed or severity reduced. Adapt healthy lifestyle behavior from childhood. Keep weight and body mass index less than 26. Physically active within limitation. Most prevalent chronic condition in later life. Arthritis, hypertension, coronary artery disease, hearing impairments, musculoskeletal impairments, diabetes, visual impairments, chronic respiratory disease, and depression. Most feared condition in later life. Alzheimer's disease. Dementia, stroke, and cancer. Physical disability that prevents independence and autonomy of normal life. For example, Parkinson's disease, heart disease, and chronic pulmonary disorder, and deafness or blindness. Adverse drug reactions, polypharmacy, and iatrogenic disease are common and often preventable. factors in older adults that increase drug reaction risk. Hepatic blood flow reduced 40% in older adults. Reduced first pass clearance. Renal blood flow reduced 50% by age 80. Creatinine clearance decreased by 10%. And chronic kidney disease. Congestive heart failure affects 40% by age 80. Drug distribution altered in your older adults. Serum proteins reduced and low learn body weight to body fat. Adverse effects. Predictor of adverse drug effects in elderly. Age 85 years or older. Multiple chronic medical conditions, 6 or more. Creatinine clearance decreased 50. Low body mass index and polypharmacy. Medication number 9 or more. More than 12 medication doses daily. Medications to use lower doses and decreased tolerance. These drugs decreased renal to clearance. I mean glucosides, vancomycin, fluoroquinolones, penicillins, imipenem, digoxin, ACE inhibitors, beta blockers, glyburide, ranitidine. Cimetidine, famotidine, and lithium. What drugs decrease hepatic clearance in elderly? Benzodiazepines, calcium channel blockers, lidocaine, phenytoin, celecoxib, terfilin, imipramine. Pramine or dizepramine, trazodone and tizidinazid and procainamide. If you administer the drug decreased renal clearance, check renal function before starting agents and periodically. A dose adjustment may be needed. This table for plasma health life in young and old. We can see drugs in which plasma health life increase. Penicillin G, tetracycline, digoxin, diazepam, lidocaine, chlordiazepoxide, phenobarbital, warfarin. The BERS criteria for potentially inappropriate medication use in older adults, commonly called the BERS list, are guidelines for healthcare professionals to help improve the safety of prescribing medication in older adults. They emphasize deprescribing medication that are unnecessary, which helps to reduce the problems of polypharmacy, drug interactions, and adverse drug reaction. Thereby improving the risk-benefit ratio of medication regimen at at-risk people. Mark Beers created this criteria, and then this update. This is medications which avoid an age of more than 65 short list. Sedative antihistamines. Benzodiazepines, tricyclic antidepressants, antispasmodics, barbiturates, antipsychotics, nitrofurantoin, antithrombotics, and alpha blockers. Some antiarrhythmic drugs, some alpha agonist central and nifedipine, digoxin, and non cyclooxygenase selective NSAIDs. Not all potentially inappropriate medication can be avoided. Clinical should involve patients in chat decision making and individualized prescribing decisions based on medical, functional, and social conditions, quality of life, and prognosis. All substances are poisons. There is none which is not. The right dose differentiate poison from a remedy. This is Paracelsus in 1000, in 1493-1541. Okay, this is maybe all. Thank you for your attention.